Hello friends, welcome to our channel Knowledge Amplifier. So today in this particular video, I am going to discuss how you can send email notification from Snowflake using external function. Okay. So already in my previous video, I have explained in detail about the fundamental concept of external function, how to do complete setup and how to integrate with the AWS API Gateway, Lambda and Snowflake external function. Regarding these concepts, if you want to know in detail, please go through the link given in the description box, because already I covered this in my earlier videos, right? So in this particular video, I am going to just discuss one particular business use case related to external function, okay, which you can use in your particular pipeline design. Suppose the business requirement is business want to send email notification when something fails in a pipeline that is in your ETL process, whether that is in data loading or transformation, etc. Right? Is it possible to send an email alert in such cases from Snowflake without using other ETL tools like Python or PySpark? And the answer is yes, it is possible. All we need to do, we need to create one Snowflake external function which will hit API Gateway, which will send all the information like through which email ID we want to send the mail, what is the receiver mail ID, what is the subject of the mail, what is the body part of the mail. If these particular things we can share from external functions Snowflake, then we can pass that to API Gateway. API Gateway will trigger Lambda. Lambda using simple email service can send the mail easily, right? So this is the pipeline whatever we are going to generate in our this particular tutorial, right? So without any further delay, let us directly jump into AWS Management Console. Then first step will be, I will be going with IAM. Okay. So for Lambda, what is the main backend server for this particular external function? Some roles are needed, right? So we are going to create the role for Lambda first. Okay. So I will click on next permission. And then here, I will search for ACS, simple email service, full access. Apart from that, I will give CloudWatch. Okay. CloudWatch full access. Then apart from that, I will give API Gateway also. So here, info full access. Okay. So these three more or less sufficient for the time being. If something required, we'll add in future time. So Lambda email demo. Okay. So this is the step one. Please keep a note of all these steps, whatever you are doing, so that you can refer in future. Okay, Lambda role is done. Now I will minimize this particular one, and then here I will click on create role, right? So here our Lambda role is created. Now we will go to new tab here on AWS Management Console. I'll be going to Lambda, and then here I will create a function, and then here email Snowflake, okay, demo, and then here I will be choosing Python 3.9 for demonstration purpose. Execution role, just now what we created, will be changing to that one, okay, this particular one, and then here we create the function. Okay, so how our Lambda function looks, it is very simple. Import JSON, import Porto 3, then we are creating the client for simple email service which we use to send the mails. This is our Lambda handler function with default parameters as input to the function. We are printing the event, and then we are iterating in our event data. Okay, this is how Snowflake sends the data in Lambda, right? All this I have discussed in detail in my previous videos, you can refer the link. So we are expecting four important parameters. One is from address in the second element of this particular array. Okay, then to address, to which email we want to send. Then what is the subject of the email, what is the body part. Okay, then we are creating the message for ACS or simple email service, how we generally do. And then here we are using client.sendMail to send the mail, using from address, to address, and the message part, right? So this is pretty much it about the Lambda main function. And then here we are appending notification sent successfully like that in the status. Status is one empty array what we created here. Okay, if you want, you can add some other message also as successful indicator. Okay, or if you want, you can add try catch block also, and then finally we are returning as we follow for Snowflake external function, right? So here I will be copying this particular piece of code. Till here I'll be copying this one, and then here I'll be going to my lambda function, deleting this piece that here, okay, deploy this, okay. Now here our main code is deployed. I'll be providing this code in the description box, so you can refer that one. Now what is the next step? As a next step, we need to go ahead with API gateway integration, right? So here I will be going to API gateway, and then here I will be going to REST API creation, and then here I will click on OK. I'll create a new API, and then here API name, email demo. Okay, I will create this API, right? And then here I will be first creating a resource. Okay, hello world. Okay, I'll be copying this and saving that for future reference. Okay, right, and then here create the resource. So our resource is created. Now we create the method. So here we need post method. I will check this particular one. What is the lambda integrator? That is this particular one what we created. We will click on save, click on OK, right? And then here this is our whole diagram. We will simply deploy this API. Okay, so here I will give dev. I will click on deploy. Okay, so this is our info URL. I'll be copying this particular one, and this is our basically resource path. Before resource path, we'll be putting that with one slash. Okay, so this particular piece is our main URL, and this is our basically resource path. Okay, so we are all good up to this, and as a next step, we'll be going to Snowflake. And then here we need to put some code. Okay, so that code also I'll be providing in the description box or in the comment section. No need to worry about a single line of code. So this is the one. So first we are dropping the database Ramu if it is existing. Make sure you are in account admin role, because this kind of S3 integration or AWS integration and this Snowflake external function creation, this role is very helpful. Okay. Then here we are creating the database if not exist. If I make this bigger, if I refresh this one, see here, database Ramu successfully created. Okay. Then here we'll click on use Ramu. Okay, it is done. Then here we need to create the API integration. So for that we need to create one IAM role. So here we will go to create role, and then here another AWS account, and then here account ID. From here we'll get account ID. We will get from security credentials, right? So we'll be going here, and then here we'll be copying this particular account ID. We'll be going back here, and external ID also we have to give, which is basically some zero values I am giving for the time being. Later we will change. Okay, and then here I will be giving all possible access to this particular role, so that we will not be getting issue with this. Okay, so API gateway info, then CloudWatch also. Okay, and then I will give ACS also, right? Next tags, next review, Snowflake, email demo. Okay, I'll create this role. All right, so here this is the Snowflake, this is the one which is created, right? So we'll choose this particular one, and then here we'll copy this particular ARN. We'll be going back here. We have to put the ARN here, right? Then here API prefix. What is our API gateway? Our API is this particular one, right? We'll be copying this particular one, and then here we will paste it. Okay, we will create this. It is done. And if we describe this integration object, here we'll be getting some information. So we'll be copying this user ARN. And then here we'll be going back to this IAM, okay, which basically we created for Snowflake, right? So here we need to go to trust relationship and edit trust relationship, and then here instead of this one you need to put that user. Okay, so all this I am going little bit fast because already I discussed multiple times. External ID also I'll be copying, and then here I'll be pasting that. Okay, I'll update this trust relationship. So we are all set with this, and then here we will execute some more codes. So here we are creating external function hello email world. So this is our basically API endpoint. We'll be copying this and then paste that here also. So this is our external function. Point to be noted, in the external function input, see there are four inputs we are giving: sender, receiver, subject, body text. Okay, the same way we are using in our lambda also. See, sender means from where we are sending, from address to address, subject, body, right? So order you should keep a very important point, that order make sure it is same. Okay, then it is done, and now here we can use this hello mail world as a function to send the mails. Okay, as before going ahead with this particular one, as a last step we need to verify the mail addresses with our simple email service also, otherwise it will not send the mail, right? So here I will search for ACS simple email service, and for this discussion purpose I created two dummy mail ID. One is this particular one, I'll be copying that, and then here email addresses I'll be going, verify new email address, I'll be pasting that, and verify address, close. It is showing pending verification. If I go back to my mail, see here mail came, I'll be clicking on this particular link, that's it. Okay, so when I click on this particular link, it is done. So if I go back to simple email service and then refresh this particular page, you will see that it is verified. Okay, one more mail we need, that is one is sender, one is receiver, right? So here I will click on verify new email address, I'll be putting this, verify this email address, close. It is pending verification. If I go to that another mail, here I'll be getting this. Okay, so you just verify your required source destination mail address in the ACS. Okay, so here I'll be refreshing this particular one, and then here both are verified, so we are all set, right? So we can use these mail IDs now to send or receive information. Okay, I'll be copying this particular one. Maybe this is the sender. Okay, so suppose this is the sender and the receiver is this particular mail ID. Okay, copying this and here is that. Okay, and then next one is subject. Okay, so subject we can give, suppose one ETL pipeline failed, that kind of notification you want to share. So here you can give alert. Okay, ETL pipeline failed. Okay, so this is our mail subject, and what will be the body? Please check the logs to debug the error. Okay, like this kind of dummy message I am showing for display purpose. Okay, so this is sender mail address, this is receiver mail address, this is the subject, and this is the body, right? So let's run this particular one and let's see what we are getting. Okay, so here see notification sent successfully. We are getting, from where we are getting? Here we send the one, right? Notification sent, that's what it is receiving back here. So as a result, what we should see, that in this particular receiver mail address, from this particular sender mail address, this particular message should be going, that is please check the log for debug the to debug the error, and this is the subject. Okay, let us see that. So I'll be going back to my destination mail address, I'll be clicking on inbox, and see from sender side one mail came, alert ETL pipeline failed 0 minutes ago, that is just now it came, right? Please check the logs to debug the error. Okay, so like this way, this kind of simple SQL function you can use to send maybe some information to business team. Okay, that is what is the current state, some business related information, some logs, anything you can share, right, in a simple way using SQL function. So I hope you understood this particular concept or use case also. All the related codes I'll be providing in the description box or in the comment section. If you find this video helpful, then please like, share and comment, subscribe our channel if you haven't subscribed till now, and don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our latest videos. Thank you.